Shame on the Dawat. Just shame.
Shame yourself, Hatun. Hatun. You are shaming
yourself.
We're coming for you, champs.
So he has a human
nature.
Because you come here. You come here.
Why do you worship?
Come here. You know, you believe in your Bible. The Bible said woman should cover their hair. You don't cover your hair, man. Let me. Okay, why aren't you covering your hair?
Let me. That's the question.
Why aren't you covering your hair? I'm asking you.
I said,
why aren't you covering your hair first? If you don't believe your Bible,
okay. I'm gonna respond to your question.
You don't believe your Bible?
I'm gonna respond to your question. And then I'm gonna ask the question, and then I would expect the same. Covering my hair, what is this, brother? What is this?
Hair.
Hair. That's my hair. Covering.
Oh, yeah.
That's my head covering.
You're not even listening. Say it again.
Did you listen?
I'm listening, sir. Say it.
Okay, can you put your listening face? Yeah. This is your listening face.
I said, okay. Why you're gone?
Sir, this is your listening face.
Yeah.
Brother, what is this?
Hair.
Sir, what is this?
Hair.
Sir, what is this?
Hair.
That's my hair, head covering.
That's the covering.
That's my head covering. Sir.
No, just it's not covered.
Sir, just a moment. I cover my hair with my head, with my hair.
No.
Does not affect my salvation. But my question to you affects your salvation.
No, I'll tell you, I'll answer that.
I haven't finished my statement. Why do you worship sinful and dead person called Muhammad?
Listen to me. You haven't addressed that. What did your Bible say about that? About covering the hair? First Corinthians, do you know? You haven't read your Bible.
Listen to me.
No. But what the Bible said, covering your hair.
Let me read it now.
Listen to me. What the Bible said.
Let's read it now.
Let's
read it now.
What you read it?
I'm going to read what you're talking about.
What you're
talking
about.
Just let me read. Can I read?
Where are you reading?
Can I? 1 Corinthians 11. Can I read?
That's the passage he's bringing.
Be ye followers of me, even as I also am of Christ. Now listen. Now I praise these brethren, that you remember me in all things, and keep the ordinances as I deliver them to you. But I would have you know that the head of every man is Christ.
That's not what I'm talking about.
My friend, let me read.
Can
I
just read?
What are you talking about?
The Bible said the woman who prophesied with
that covenant. My friend, this is it.
Should he chop off my head? This is it.
Okay, you know
this is it. It shows you how much you know. It shows you how much you know.
That's right.
It shows you how much you know. Can I finish?
Have you been caught on your side?
You've been shouting.
Lami, let's get some context.
You be screaming!
Yeah, okay.
Read it.
Go on.
So,
because the Bible said a lot about you that you don't even know.
I'm reading the word of God. Listen carefully.
No, I'm talking to you.
Is this your listening face? Put your listening face. Okay?
And then talk your squeaky voice, your boring voice. Go.
You came to me.
Go then. But you're disturbing brothers, they don't know. You said they are running away from Islam. That's why I came to you. Go read it.
I'm reading the word of God. I expect it to have a respected word of God. 1 Corinthians chapter 11. I'm starting from verse 2.
Read it.
I praise you for remembering me in everything and for holding to the teaching just as I passed them on to you. Now, I want you to realize that the head of every man is Christ.
What are you reading?
Listen.
Head of every woman. And head of every woman is man. And the head of Christ is
God. Thank you.
Every man who prays or prophesies with his head covered dishonors his head. And every woman who prays and prophesies with her head uncovered dishonors her head. It is just as though her head was shaved. If a woman does not cover her head, she should have her hair cut off.
Listen.
And if it is a disgrace for a woman to to have her, her hair cut off, cut or shaved off. She should cover her head. A man ought to not cover his head, since he is the image and glory of God. But the woman is the glory of man. For man did not come from woman, but woman come from man.
Woman come from man.
Was man created for woman, but not
for it, all of it. I don't want to read the whole Bible.
For this reason, and because of the angels, the woman ought to have a sign of authority over her head in the world, in the Lord. However, woman is not independent of man. Oh, you don't understand my English.
No, he does that. It's better in fact.
He's pretending to be an ignorant.
I know. It's the cameraman again. You're pretending to be an ignorant.
You ask a question.
Keep quiet.
Woman is not independent of man, nor is man independent of woman. For as woman came from man, and also man is born of woman. But everything comes from God. Judge for yourself. Judge for yourself. It is proper for woman to pray to God with her head uncovered. Long hair is given to her as a covering.
Did you hear that?
Her hair is given to her for a covering.
Listen to me. Hold on, ma'am. Mary, the mother of Jesus, was it? Pious woman, covered her hair and body.
Lamin, you're not listening.
Sister Hassan has explained clearly. She has explained clearly that the hair is a covering, and she has used a scripture. This con man is not listening. Mohammed, you're a con man. You're not listening. Mohammed, you're a con man. You're not listening. She has explained clearly that the hair is a covering. The hair is a covering. You asked the question, where is her covering? She has no covering. You haven't listened, Mohammed.
Adam wasn't deceived.
You're trying to run the flood.
Is deceived and become a transgressor.
You have no argument.
The Bible says you're a transgressor. That's a different subject.
You're fooling no one.
The question you asked, they're scared.
That's why you won't let me see.
The question you asked is about who's going to be here.
You're going to get a heart attack. You don't know the scriptures. You have been sprung. He's been sprung. The question is simple. He said, why don't she cover her hair? And she told him that her hair is a covering, and she used the scriptures to show that her hair is a covering. End of question.
First of all,
do you have another question? Mommy, do you have another question?
Many questions.
The grace woman. Can we ask you? Can we ask you one now?
The Bible.
Can I ask you a question?
The Bible.
Can I ask you a question?
I want to ask a question.
My question last week.
My question is, who was on the cross?
The Jews boasted that they killed the Messiah.
But they killed him not. Neither did they crucify him. Question: if they didn't kill Jesus, who did they kill?
Who was on the cross?
I just quoted it, my friend. He said they killed him not, neither did they crucify him. So they didn't kill Jesus, and neither did they crucify him. So my question is, who did they kill? Who did they kill?
Did not die.
You're just repeating yourself. Who did they kill?
What is the reference?
Just answer the question. He has no answer. And the Quran has no answer. Who did they kill? Who did the Jews kill?
Listen to me.
Who did the Jews kill? Answer my question. The Quran is lying. That's the biggest lie in history. The Quran is lying. Answer the question.
Listen to me.
Who did the Jews kill? They didn't kill the Messiah, neither did they crucify him. So who did? Yes, and he starts with a question.
I've got plenty of questions.
My debate starts.
You just asked one.
He just asked a question about hair covering, and we answered it. Now I'm asking you.
Everybody's witnessing.
You're not answering the question. Everybody's a witness.
He did not answer
that question. I asked you a simple question. Everybody can hear.
Who did the Jews kill? Three times. Who did the Jews kill? Answer. Look at the Bible. Look at the Quran. It's a question.
Who did the Jews kill?
Jesus is God.
Simple question.
Who did the Jews kill?
You know that Jesus is God.
Who did the Jews kill?
You're asking questions.
Why don't you answer the question? Why don't you answer? It is important.
They kill him not.
No. Who did they kill? Who did they kill? I'm asking you. Who did they kill?
He doesn't want to answer. The most crucial question. The Quran has told a lie. It said that he didn't kill Jesus.
Yet they don't know who they killed. They said they didn't kill Messiah. Who did they kill?
Does anyone else want to answer? Is there a Muslim that wants to answer? Who died on the cross? It wasn't Jesus. Who died on the cross? Does any Muslim know? Who died on the cross?
You said they killed your God.
Who died on the cross?
You said they killed your God.
It's a simple question.
They killed your God.
Who was it?
You said they killed your God.
And you said they didn't.
Hey,
so I'm asking you, who did they kill?
Did they kill your God?
Who did they kill?
Did they kill your God? Answer.
Did they kill your God?
This is the guy that wants to be a scholar. I'm asking a simple question, Mohammed. You said I don't know the Bible.
You claim to know the Bible.
You can't go.
And I'm not running. I'm not running. I'm not running. I'm not running. So Bob ran. Everybody's running. I'm not running. I'm not running. Let's have one. Let's have one. So everybody ran. I'm not running. I'm not running.
You know, he released a video.
I'm not running. I'm not running. And you won't answer my question.
Listen, you know, I debated with you.
Yes.
This is a different subject.
Let me finish. It's a different subject.
Let me finish. Let me finish. I exposed you.
Okay.
When I was on holiday.
Well done.
You released a video.
Well done.
I wanted to know the debate.
And you didn't give me one. Huh? And you haven't given me one, so let's have it now. Right, and it starts with a question. We're debating.
I don't want a question.
We're debating Surah. Okay, right, okay. We're debating Surah.
That's not debate.
No, it's a question.
No, I don't want a question.
You can't debate. Why? Because you can't answer. Look, what do you want to debate? Okay, what do you want to debate? What do you want to debate?
Let me finish.
What do you want to debate?
Let me finish.
What do you want to debate?
You know your Bible.
Listen to me. I know my Bible. Better than you.
Listen, better than you.
Better than you.
What is the first commandment?
10 times better than you.
What is the first commandment?
Don't patronize.
He doesn't know.
Don't patronize me.
Ask me. Ask him.
Answer my question.
He was embarrassed. Who killed the Messiah?
No 500 pounds. You owe 500 pounds. You need to pay up your debt. I am the bailiff. I am the bailiff.
Debate with you.
The last debate you did, you failed. You said you couldn't answer. Why I let Satan? Why did you answer? Why I let Satan? So why is Allah Satan? Why is... Oh, he's put the Bible away. You're running now. Answer the question to the surah. Why was Muhammad praying to the shaitan?
Ask him again.
Answer this question. Why was Muhammad's Lord the shaitan?
So they didn't kill Jesus. They didn't kill the Messiah. They didn't crucify him. So my question is, who did they kill? Who did they kill?
We have that sword, that printed copy.
No, I don't have it.
I wish
you
had it.
You don't even need it, man. This guy's a joker.
What's in the book you're in?
Who did they kill?
What's in the book you're in?
I don't understand what you're talking about.
You mean you don't understand? There's four books you're in. What's in them you read?
That's right. How much of them you read?
How much of them you read?
Mandinka.
It's a simple question. Who did they kill?
Mohammed. The four books. The Quran.
I'm asking Khalif Lamin. Khalif Lamin. I answer this simple question. It's a simple question. Surah 415 says the Jews boasted that they killed the Messiah. Paraphrasing. But they killed him not. Neither did they crucify him. My simple question to Khalif Lamin was, who did they kill? And he won't answer the question. So we established that they didn't kill the Messiah. Who did they kill? That's the question. That's the biggest lie in the Quran. He said it's not important. It's very important for this simple reason. If that surah is true, then my faith is in vain. However, if that surah is false, then their faith is in vain. So you need to answer the question. If you've established that they didn't kill the Messiah, you must know who they killed in his place. That's the question. Who did they kill? This scholar will not answer. That's my question for Muslims. Who did they kill? The biggest lie in the Quran. Will someone please answer the question? Thank you.